Hello guys, good to see you again. So, I'm back here to answer all of your questions. Just stop it. Alright, the first question, I thought it's gonna be actually the most liked one. Basically, whatever happened to the Eldvak project, and there's another one, will there be more collaborations with other YouTubers? Well, the thing is, I honestly also don't know what is going on with the Eldvak project. For sure it's not that, but the thing is, like, you can imagine that Ola Englund and I am, we're very busy right now, and we created that project when we had, like, not so much stuff to do. We have our priorities, obviously, you know, we have Septic Flash, we have The Haunted, he has his solo project, I have my solo project, and it's just too much. A day has 24 hours and we have to sleep and eat as well, I'm sorry. I write him sometimes to ask, like, hey, what's going on? Do we have any new riffs? Let's do something. He's like, yeah, I have some ideas, but you know, it needs a bit more work. But we're famous with like one song. Yeah. And the second question was, will there be more collaboration with other YouTubers? Honestly, I think I've only done one so far. And it was a Dimmu Borgir cover back in the days with a Norwegian guitar player, Michael. I cannot promise this that there will be more collaborations. If there is someone that I think like it could be cool to make something together, I would say definitely yes. And if my schedule will let me do so. As I said, I try to make more videos. Let's see if this is gonna happen. Second question. When and why did you decide to become a professional drummer? That was written by Nechtan, by the way, very cool drummer, Grüße nach Deutschland. Well, I think it was actually back in 2009, yeah. I mean, I recorded my first YouTube videos in 2007, and that was more out of fun. I realized, like, hey, actually, there's such a good response happening that maybe in the future I can achieve my dream becoming a professional drummer and musician. But it was like 2009 when Decapitated wrote to me that they're looking for a new drummer. I kind of knew, like, okay, this is basically my chance to achieve my dreams and to achieve my goals. I just put everything on one card, literally, and decided to join the band and go to Poland and see what will happen, honestly. Third question. It's actually about Decapitated. Why did you left Decapitated? Honestly, I never knew the truth behind that. First of all, mention that I don't want to have any bad blood with Decapitated. We're all good buddies, and I think just out of respect, I don't want to have any bullshit between us. I always mention this in every interview I do, that I'm very, very grateful for, you know, that Decapitated actually took me on board and let me play with them for a couple of years. As I said before, this was my first professional band. I recorded the first professional album with them. I started to tour all around the world. I've been to places I've never been in my whole life. I have done the first music videos with them. I just felt like I wanna develop in a musical way, and I just felt also that maybe personally we are not 100%. We don't fit that well together. I mean, we're good friends, you know, we can hang out, and I really enjoyed the time I had with them. It was not only bad stuff, of course, there was a lot of amazing experience with the guys. And yeah, so I made the decision to move on and see what else I can achieve. Challenge myself, but I wish them all the best. Awesome band. And like I said, no bad blood between us. Question number four. Actually, this one I really like a lot. What has been the most difficult part of being a professional musician? It's not easy at all, just to tell you the truth. The financial situation, I think I have to mention this first of all. CD sales are not the same anymore. People in general don't have much money. You have to decide, do you pay your rent, do you pay the insurance for a car, or you go on a concert. Sometimes it's like, nah, I have to stay at home because I don't have that much money. Which means the business became harder, I think, than it used to be. The really difficult part, in my opinion, is you have the life as a musician. The musician doesn't really care about if it's Monday, Sunday, weekend, if there is holidays or not. Basically, every day is the same. Either I'm on tour or I don't have to do anything. And with a usual job, you start on Monday, and you finish on Friday, and then you have your weekend. We're more flexible, and we kind of, we're gone for like a month or longer if we're on tour, and we don't see our friends, family. Yeah, so this is pretty difficult to just have the world of a musician combined with the regular life, because our system is basically designed to have a steady income. You kind of know how much you will get per month, and all the costs are monthly there. You have to pay the rent, you have to pay the insurance, you have to pay the car, blah, 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 you have to buy food. So with a musician, it's kind of on and off. You have times where you earn not bad, and there are times where you earn like almost nothing, especially when you have to be creative, like you're writing an album. It can be that you have no income for, let's say, half a year, because you basically spend the whole day just finding ideas, writing songs, writing drum beats, and there is no time and no energy to actually do something else which would generate money. You make most of the income with playing shows. And so it's always a struggle to reinvent yourself. You have to always find a plan B. Of course, you can give lessons, you can do session jobs. But as I said, if you are creative and you have to deliver a new album, you just focus on that and nothing else, honestly. Another difficult part would be that you need really a strong support from your friends, family and partners, because you just, most of the time, you're not there. It's hard for them to accept that sometimes, but it's a beautiful job. For me, money is of course something important, because you know I have to live from something, but on the other hand, the freedom and I get from this job in a way, and what I see and how many countries I've visited, I just think that for me as a person, it really changed the view of everything after traveling for so many years and meet so many different cultures. All right, so let's move on. Question number 5. What has been your favorite band to tour with? I've played with a lot of amazing bands, but I must say Meshuggah back in 2012. I think that was like the most impressive live show I have seen. We played like 3 weeks tour. It was a package, Decapitated and Meshuggah, and I watched them every single day, and I was not even bored once. Meshuggah is definitely on the top. I like with everything: songwriting, stage performance, light, amazing band. All right, question number 6. Hi Krim, I know you've done a lot of covers over the years, but what was it like when a band asked you to actually play the drums for them? For the ones you've done drum covers. But that actually happened with Decapitated. You know, it was quite a shock. I must say that the whole YouTube thing kind of worked, that literally a big band is watching my videos. Because first of all, I thought like those kind of professional musicians and all the bands I've looked up to, they're like unreachable. But on the other hand, now being in the business, I just see that, well, all the bands I've looked up to, and they're still, you know, one of my favorite bands, they're watching YouTube videos and check out what's going on, of course, and they're actually the most down-to-earth people you can imagine. Question number 7, alright, that's a bit the longer one. What you're asking is, tell me brother, what do you think of chant prog metal music? Have you ever considered playing in a band like this? I must say that, you know, the whole chant genre is for me kind of overplayed already. It's the same thing when it was back with new metal, everyone started to play new metal when it became a fashion, then metalcore thing came up and everyone started to play metalcore, and now all the bands are switching into chant bands, and I do like some elements. I do really like some elements of this genre, but I don't see myself playing in such a band. My drumming is too old school in a way, and I wanna have a bit more freedom when I'm playing, and I feel like when I would play in a chant band, you have to be really precise with all the accents, you know, because that's what it's all about. And I think I would spend a lot of time to just figure out all those grooves. For me, it's not easy to play this kind of music. I would have to sit down and write everything down and just try to get it into my brain. Cool genre, but just like too much and too many bands. So this one is a typical question. Can you name top 5 of your drummers? What? So can you name top 5 of your favorite drummers? Without any particular order, I'm just throwing out a couple of names, but of course I must say Joey Jordison. When I was beginning to play metal drums, he was kind of my idol, and I really liked what he was doing. Mario from Gojira, amazing drummer, one of my favorite of all time for sure. I must say Nicholas Parker, really amazing drummer. Eloy Casagrande, do I have to even mention any comments? Just Google Ilar Casagrande, watch what he's doing, and yeah, you will understand why.
Who else?
Yeah, Kevin Harrison. Really, the way how he plays, it's very tasty. And in general, I think every drummer can be an inspiration, you know, even if you just go on any gig and you just watch the drummer, what he's doing. And I have it so many times that I see a support band and I'm just amazed the level of skill they have, how tasty most of those drummers are playing. Those drummers I just mentioned are a couple, you know, because I also have to mention Daniel Erlandsson, I have to mention Chris Adler, that's just too many. But every drummer can be an inspiration, honestly. What's the weirdest way you've ended up playing in a band or any project? I've never really ended up in a weird way. It was most of the time either an email or someone just called me. In the case with Behemoth, it was like this, that I basically just got a phone call and almost shit my pants while I answered it because I didn't expect such a phone call. But it was like, okay, do it. You have this chance right now. Do you say yes or no? We give you one day. All right. Besides that, the weirdest way was probably also again with Decapitated and YouTube. Because when I started to do the covers, I was like, nah, probably nobody's gonna watch it. I just recorded for myself. Let's put it on. Why not? And then honestly, someone is actually writing to you. Someone you just made a cover from and they want you in the band. So it's like, what the fuck? Okay, last question. Opa, that's a big one. So where is the question in this? Actually, it is here. My question is, through so many years now, and being at the level you are now in terms of drumming, how have you seen your technique change, evolve over the time? And are there things that you still feel like you struggle with or want to improve upon? There's a lot of stuff I'm still struggling with. For me, the hardest thing, honestly, is to keep up the level of, not speed, but the general level. Let's say I have a bad day when I'm on tour, I still want to give 100% and I want that it sounds like every day the same. You have to imagine if you play 25 shows with like not a single day off, it can be very tiring and still you have to deliver, and it's very exhausting fast stuff. That's why it requires a lot of practice and a lot of tips and tricks. You have to understand your body very well. Okay, today my hands are very tired, or today I'm in general, you know, I'm just really smashed, and how to trick yourself to be still able to pull it off. I think this is the most difficult thing and I focus a lot on. And another thing is, I'm not really interested into learning any new techniques. I just feel like I've reached what I want to learn in terms of technique. I'm not interested into like learning double strokes and the kicks to just play faster. I like the speed I've achieved, but I try now to actually listen to what I'm doing. Okay, I should have done that before, but I just feel like now after more than 10 years of playing, I realized it's not only important like what you play, but also like how you play certain things. And especially when you will record quite a lot of albums, you will realize that a microphone listens different, you know, than your ear. You will change your playing. Sometimes it's not very useful to just smash the cymbals as hard as you can. So those are things you learn during many years of playing. This is not something which you don't have from the beginning on, in my opinion. And this is the thing I really focus on. So take this, what I'm doing, and just listen to it and just try to find the best possible way of this beat, let's say, and just to play it as tasty as possible. And yeah, it's still a struggle just to keep up the level. You know, there's so many amazing young drummers and I've done this for like 7 years right now. And yeah, I'm not getting younger, I'm just saying. So certain things are very difficult just to keep up the stamina and stuff. Okay guys, thank you very much for all the questions. I'm sorry if I couldn't reply to all of them. There were just too many. I just picked the 10 on the top. Maybe in the future we'll make another one, but yeah, thank you very much for all the questions. I will try to reply maybe just by writing back to the other ones. Just a little product placement right now. If you guys would like to support me, of course you can subscribe and follow me on all the social media, or just pick up some of my t-shirts, like this one for example, or maybe grab one of the CDs I have out. So I really would appreciate that. Thank you very much and see ya.